Hi friends, welcome to the class of formal language and automata theory. Coming to the question number 12, construct DFA which accepts set of all strings over 0, 1 which when interpreted as binary number divisible by 3. So it is asking for binary number divisible by 3. What are the numbers that are divisible by 3? First of all, we'll take. So 0, yes, it is divisible. 3, 6, 9, 12, like this. So first we need to convert this into binary. So 0, it may be 0. 3, if I convert it into binary, it will be 11. 6, if I convert, it will be 110. For 9, it will be 1001. And if you take for 12, this is 1100. Like this, we can have in binary representation. This is a decimal representation. This is a binary representation. So here it is asking, accept all strings over 0, 1. So we'll see how to solve this problem. Now I'll start from initial state Q0. Anyway, we have three states required, that is 0 remainder state, 1 remainder state and 2 remainder state. That's why, because it is divisible by 3. Only 3 remainders we'll find. Q0 is 0 remainder state, Q1 is 1 remainder state. I'll take Q2, which is 2 remainder state. Now for zero, if let us consider, so anyway this is a DFA, that means every state will have all the input paths exactly once. We'll see that first. So Q0 to 0, where it has to go? From Q0 to 0, if I give, where it has to go? 0 in the sense first symbol. So if I give 0, it is divisible, that's why it has to go to 0 remainder state. Now if I give 0 1, what is 0 1? This number in binary, 1 means the remainder state is 1 state, so that's why it is going to 1. Now you can check out, Q0 to 0 is over, Q0 to 1 is over. What about Q1? Q1 to 0, where it needs to go? So if I give 0 at Q1, that means how you are reaching to Q1 from Q0? By giving 1. That means 1 followed by 0. What is 1 followed by 0? Of course in decimal 10 is given as 2. So 2 in the sense which is a remainder 2 state. So from Q1, if I give 0, it has to go to 2 remainder state. What is 2 remainder state? Q2. So if I give 0, it has to go to 2 remainder state. From Q1, if I give 1, what it needs to go? That means after 1 followed by 1, if I give 1 1, means it is 3. So 3 means which is a 0 remainder state. That means from Q1, if I give 1, it has to go for 0 remainder state. That means it will directly go for Q0. Now Q1 to 0 is over, Q1 to 1 is over. Now Q2 to 0, if I give, where it needs to go? That means before reaching to Q2, that means how you are reaching to Q2, first you need to check it out. So how you are reaching from Q0? Q0 to 1 you are giving, after that 0 you are giving. That means after 10 you are giving 0. What is 100? Which is 4 in decimal. So 4 in the sense which is a, if I divide with 3, the remainder is 1. That means it has to go to 1 remainder state. So where is 1 remainder state? So Q1 is a 1 remainder state. So it has to go to Q1. If I give 0 here. Now at Q2, if I give 1, what happens? 101. That means which is 5. 5 means which is 2 remainder state. Where is 2 remainder state? Q2 itself. That's why self loop here. Now you see whether it is a DFA or not. Q0 to 0, yes. Q0 to 1, yes. Q1 to 1, Q1 to 0, yes. Q2 to 0, yes. Q2 to 1 is also there. Now if you have, let us suppose if you have doubt, you can check it out. If I give 12, where it will go? 1100. So Q0 to 1, it is going to Q1. Q1 to 1, it is going to Q0. Q0 to 0, self loop. Again Q0 to 0, self loop. So that's why finally it is going to Q0, which is a final state. You can take any number. Like let us suppose if I take 33. So 33 in binary can be taken as 100001. So now can you check it? If you divide with 3, you will get remainder 0. That means it has to go to final state. That is Q0. Check it out. 1, Q0 to 1. What is Q0 to 1? Q1. Q1 q1 to 0. So it is going to q2. q2 to 0, it is coming to q1. q1 to 0, it is coming to q2. q2 to 0, it is coming to q1. q1 to 1, yes, it is going to q0. So final state. So 33 also will be accepted. If you want, you can check it out for something with the remainders, other remainders. Like, let us suppose if I take the number 11. 11 in the sense, the remainder you need to get as 2. So that means it has to go to q2. The binary representation of 11 is 1011. So check it out for 1011. So q0 to 1, q1. q1 to 0, q2. q2 to 1, q2. q2 to 1, q2. Yes. So these are two remainder state. That means 11, if you divide with 11, you will go to two remainder state. So like this, you need to analyze when it is interpreted as binary number that is divisible by some number. So we'll see some more questions in the next video lecture. Thank you.